November is Diabetes Awareness Month, and someone you know or love, or even you, may be pre-diabetic or diabetic. Our medical contributor, Dr. Ogechika Alozie with Sunset West Health, is here with some things that you need to know. Now, doctor, how many people in the U.S. have been diagnosed with diabetes or pre-diabetes?
So those numbers vary, right? There are some estimates it's about 30 million, some say 30.7 million. But what's really important is that the people that are at risk for diabetes, or that pre-diabetes population, is double that, right? And so you have the population that already has diabetes is on metformin, is on insulin, is on a host of other diabetic medications. And there's a lot of people that actually have the ability to protect themselves and prevent that diabetes, and that's almost 100 million people.
Well, as someone who is on metformin for pre-diabetes, I certainly know that well. Yeah. Who is at risk for diabetes or pre-diabetes?
You know, the reality is everybody. But I think the main thing is as you get older, you develop more risk. If you're obese, you're at risk. If you're somebody that has been diabetic or has a hormone condition in the past, you're at risk. You can see a lot of these things on the screen. But no, you and I talk about this all the time, right? At the end of the day, at a certain age, and I really think that's above 40, you want to have these conversations with your physician, right? Because whether it's you've gained weight, whether it's you can't exercise, whether you're on medication such as steroids that can cause diabetes, these are all things that are manageable. And that pre-diabetes that we'll talk about in a second is really the trigger for you to say, I got to do something different so I don't get to full-blown diabetes.
Now, like cholesterol or your blood pressure, diabetes is a numbers game. What are the numbers to keep in mind to prevent diabetes?
Yeah, so let's take this as a stop sign sort of a game, right? And you can see at the bottom where you should be at. So an A1C is a test that your physician or clinician can run. It determines how much sugar really is on a red blood cell over a 90-day period. You want that below 5.7. Right. If it's a fasting blood sugar, which is, hey, come get a blood test, make sure you don't eat from the night before to that morning, it should be under 100, right? 99. And then a glucose tolerance test, which we really don't do in a lot of people, most people that already have endocrine conditions or pregnant women, that should be under 140. Where we get into trouble is that orange part, right? That 5.7 to 6.4, that 100 to 125, and obviously the glucose tolerance test. But again, I think these are all things, especially as we come up on the holiday months, right? A lot of Americans gain weight between October and December every year. This is the time to look at it. This is the time to sort of reel some things back in and be a little bit more diligent about your food choices.
A couple of less pieces of pecan pie on Thanksgiving and Christmas. All right, well, maintaining your A1C is just part of managing diabetes. What else should people be doing?
I think for me, one of the biggest things is food, right? And planning your food, understanding which foods are good for you and bad for you. As somebody that has had prediabetes in the past when I was a little bit fluffier, those are the things that concerned me. I have a parent that's diabetic, and so managing holiday seasons. When you are then diabetic, making sure you take your medication. Right? A lot of people get into that mode of, I really don't want to take medication, I don't want to take shots, but those are lifesavers, right? They can prevent you from having the kidney disease, the heart disease, the eye disease, all those blood vessel complications that we talk about in diabetes. And if you're already diabetic or pre-diabetic, you really don't want to smoke, right? Follow a regimen, try to exercise as much as possible.
Now, we have some resources if our viewers have more questions. Of course, the El Paso Center for Diabetes, the main one, Project Vita also there, and also the Empower program at El Paso Children's Hospital, and that's for our younger patients.
Yeah, so we often forget or think that diabetes is only an adult issue. Children can have diabetes, not just type 1. As we've gotten what I call fluffier in our society and there's more obesity, younger kids can have diabetes. It's important for parents to manage this and monitor that. And as always, we have a ton of resources in our community.
ABC7 medical contributor Dr. Ogechika Alozie, as always, thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.